Angels bow before your throne. For from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory.
Thank you, Jesus.
You are worthy of it all. You are worthy of it all. For from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory.
It is of the pit, you know, of hell.
It's called my husband.
Yes, devil. I like to tell him, you're only going to get a couple of days. If you get a couple of days, you're only going to get a couple of days, you know. And force the body to stand up, because they said that's one of the things that you don't want to do with COVID, is lay down too long, because then it takes a hold of you, you know. And just let us know that we can speak to a devil. And even in our lesson, we're talking about how we talk to these demons or these things or these thorns that come into our lives. You know, so I'm just so grateful. You know, a couple of weeks ago I had COVID, but I am just so determined that, you know, this enemy is not going to hold us down. Amen. And hold our church down. And just speak over your family members, you know, and if they don't have the strength, that we can pray the strength for them. And I'm just thankful, Sister Demika, that you're doing better.
Amen. Born awake again. And I'm doing well. I didn't have COVID.
Yes,
amen. So I had a dose of it in December, and I only had a mild one one time, but December was terrible, and I was in bed sleeping like 3 days. Mm-hmm. But I had a girlfriend keep on calling me and saying to me, you've got to get up and go to walk. And stay in that bed. And I could feel that it was getting worse being in the bed.
Yes.
You've got to move around. Mm-hmm. She said, don't start cleaning. I did start jealous. But, you know, God is gracious, because I think it was, I was going to a bad point with her.
Yeah.
And I thank her for encouraging me. My husband was so good to me. He did do dishes and stuff.
Oh, my God.
Took care of me. Yeah. He fed us and different things. He was good. Sister Kate.
Well, I'm going to give another praise report about Layla. I got a picture of her from the other day. She still has a nasal cannula, but the cardiologist has said that she's doing well. So now that she just needs to see the pulmonologist in April to see, you know, how she's doing, if they can finally get that out. But they sent a picture of her sitting up. She's 11 and a half pounds now.
Wow.
A prayer request for a friend of Christian's. He's a boiler maker, he was on a job up in New York, and he fell like 8 stories inside a boiler, hit a bunch of things going down, which kind of broke the fall, but this happened on February 7th, and that is the last first, and he was still unconscious. He's got, you know, he's all broken up, and I guess broken the fact he's stolen. Only 31, I guess he has a family. So just the Lord, his name's Johnny G, I forget exactly what his name was, but God will know.
Yes.
So this is a testimony that the Lord
can
prayer.
Let's remember Johnny Jesus. Yeah. He sounds like a
really good
prayer. And our God is able to do it in Jesus. Anyone else? Brother Mike?
Yeah, for my brother Brian, he is sick, and also for Charlie, and for my son and daughter for to come back to the Lord. And, Jessica and Justin, and they need for salvation.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Pray for my family. Pray for all those that are not here today. Continue to keep my mother in prayer. And then please continue to pray for me even on my job. They're making decisions, and just the Lord will give you the guidance and the strength.
Yes.
And please pray for our backsliders. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
And let's remember Brother Keith and Sister Granny's daughter-in-law. She's getting ready to have her baby in March.
Yeah.
And she has a safe delivery.
Yes.
As well.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Just about a praise report. My mother went to the doctors, so she's been 2 years now cancer free, so I just thank the Lord for that.
And thank everyone that gives those praise reports. But we're praying for something.
Yes.
And it's answered. Amen. Yes.
Yes.
You have brothers and sisters that are praying for these situations that are working on Jesus. Did you have any?
Yeah, pray for the Rouse family. Rebecca's sick. Mom's not feeling well in the back. But pray for them. Civil call. She's got the same thing going on. There's many, many that have, you know, been fighting this cold. It's going around, and things are going on. So I would like everybody right now, at this very moment, let's stand.
Amen.
Let's go before the Lord.
Amen. Yes.
Amen. To come against specifically the health of the church.
Yes.
How it's being attacked with sicknesses and colds.
Yeah.
And the different things that are going around. Amen. I believe that God is going to win this battle.
Amen. Amen.
Father, Lord, in the name of Jesus, we come against sickness, God. Lord God, every turn, Lord, has got to go. In the name of Jesus, God, we do not believe, God, in the blood, Lord. God, for our healing, God, you said that by your stripes, we are healed, God. And so, Lord, send healing to our families, God. Sister Sybil, God. Lord God, hallelujah. Sally, God. Oh God, you are great. Great, great, great.
Amen. And what we'll do is, for those 21 days up until Easter, from March 9th until the 31st, those 21 days, every day, you will receive a text, an email, amen, with some instructions, some devotion, some prayer, and also a challenge to reach for somebody. Amen. Praise God. To bring them out for our Easter service. Praise God. And so that's what 21 Days of Hope is. And so if you haven't signed up for 21 Days of Hope, all you have to do is text the word HOPE, H-O-P-E, to the number you see on the screen, 856-888-4337, and you will be part of the 21-day challenge, the 21-day mission trip, I should say, that we're going to take digitally, amen, before Easter. I believe this will be a great, great outreach, amen, for us to do together as the body of Christ. Amen, and I'm looking forward to it myself. Praise God. Also, don't forget, put on the Celebrate Recovery, amen, advertisement. Praise God. We are starting Celebrate Recovery. It's the transition one, brother. It says transition. We are starting Celebrate Recovery on March 6th at 7 o'clock p.m. right here. We're going to do a step study, which will take us, amen, through the steps to, you may be seated, amen, so that we can examine ourselves. We're going to do an in-depth look into our hearts, amen, because during life, we have a tendency of picking up many different things, habits, praise God. No, that's not it, brother. Transition, that's it. Amen. Journey, we have hurts, we pick up habits, amen, that we all need delivered from.
Amen.
Amen. And so this is a way that we will be able to dig deep, amen, and find healing through Christ. The Christ-centered program, amen, He gets all the glory.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. And I'm looking forward to the beginning. That's March 6th at 7 o'clock. Amen. Praise God. If you have your Bibles, amen, turn with me to the book of Psalms. Psalms 119. Praise God. We're going to be looking at a couple verses. We're going to look at 29 and 30. And then we're also going to go to Isaiah chapter 35, verse 8. I'm going to read Psalms 119, 29 and 30. And I'm going to read that from two different translations. The first one is going to be the King James Version, which is on your screen. Amen. And that simply says this. Remove from me, everybody say me, the way of lying, and grant me thy law graciously. I have chosen the way of truth. Thy judgments have I laid before me. Now, the New Living Translation says it like this. Keep me from lying to myself.
All right.
Give me the privilege of knowing your instructions. I have chosen the way of truth. Thy judgments have I made before thee. Amen. Now go to Isaiah chapter 35. Isaiah chapter 35. Amen. And again, we can read it from two different translations. First one is King James Version, which is on the screen. Amen. And highways shall be there, and the way, and it shall be called the way of holiness. The unclean shall not pass over it, but it shall be for those the wayfaring man, though fools shall not err therein. Now I'll read that again, but this time from the New Living Translation, which says this: and a great road will go through that once deserted land. It will be named the Highway of Holiness. Evil-minded people will never travel on it. It will be only for those who walk in God's ways. Father, we love you.
Yes, sir.
God, we give you all the praise. We give you all the glory. God, I ask you to have your way, Lord God, today in this place. God, as we give you praise and glory in Jesus' name. Amen. Keith, if I could get a little bit more volume on my mic, which is the pulpit mic, probably be on the main board as well. Amen. Look for the one that says pulpit. Just slide the bar up a little bit. Thank you. That's much better. Praise God. You may be seated. Praise God. It's good to see everyone here that's here today. Amen. Good to see Kathy.
Yes.
We've missed you, Kathy. God bless you.
Yes.
Good to see Karen here today. Karen, amen. And Jennifer, right?
Yep.
I got it. Amen. Jennifer.
Yep.
Amen. We're so glad that you're here with us today. Amen. Praise God. Amen. And we're just thankful for what God is doing within people's lives. I was asked a question last week concerning the angels and their ability to choose. These beings were created in the heavenly realm, and they existed from the very creation in God's presence. Amen. They didn't know anything concerning sin or rebellion before Satan's pride affected the whole atmosphere of heaven. Pride is powerful.
Amen.
It affected the whole atmosphere of heaven. Think about that for a moment. Amen. Praise God. It's a powerful force that shook the very elements of heaven and all of creation. And the angels themselves, amen, had no reasoning of sin or choice that we're aware of until Satan's pride had affected them in that heavenly realm. Much like the man in the Garden of Eden, praise God, who only knew what the Lord had given and directed him to do and to eat, amen. And man was innocent and blameless, praise God. And matter of fact, they were so innocent in Genesis chapter 2:5, it describes it, such a difference as this. And they were both naked, the man and the wife, and were not ashamed. Amen. They had no recollection of anything evil. They had no recollection of anything. They were commanded to procreate, amen, and to multiply and fill the earth, amen. But they had no recollection of sin or shame or anything like that, amen. Until, again, Satan comes and began to pollute what was perfect. Amen. Praise God. I want to preach to you for just a few moments this morning on the topic of the power and consequences of choice. The power and consequences of choice. Amen. Maybe Adam and Eve were so covered in the glory of God, amen, that they couldn't recognize their nakedness. They couldn't recognize, amen, the state that they were in. Amen. But that's another topic for another message for another day. Amen. Today's message is simply this: freedom of choice. Praise God. We all have that freedom of choice. You're here today, praise God, because you chose to be here. You chose to come to church. You chose to worship. You chose, amen, to sing and to clap, amen, and to worship the Lord, praise God. And I believe that is the right choice to make, amen. Praise God. Your choice this morning may have been simply to go along to get along. Amen. Maybe you came just because mom and dad told you you had to go to church. Or maybe your boyfriend or girlfriend said, hey, let's go to church today. Amen. But you made the choice. Your body may be sitting here this morning, amen, but your mind and your thoughts might be miles away and engaged in other activities. You may in fact be, amen, that little boy who is being corrected and told to sit down. Be quiet. But in his mind, he says, I'm sitting on my outside, but I'm standing on the inside. Anybody know what I'm talking about? Amen. But for the next few minutes, amen, I'm going to ask that everyone in this room, everybody that's in this room, praise God, who's capable and mature enough, praise God, to reel in their thoughts, amen, from the future and focus on the right here and the right now. Praise God. Jesus Christ is present in this room today. Amen. He's here with us. Yes. Amen. If you want Him, you can have Him. You can choose, amen, to serve Him. You can choose to live for Him. You can choose, amen, that I want nothing more than to be with Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. Matter of fact, I believe He's eagerly awaiting, praise God, the choices that some may make today in this place. Praise God. Or if you're listening on Facebook today, those that are out there, amen, through the airwaves, at the end of this message today, you will have a chance to choose. Praise God. But then to put the message into action within your life. Amen. In God's infinite wisdom, our Creator made a crucial choice when He was making and deciding what He was going to do. He made a faithful decision, amen. And that word faithful, it doesn't mean that it was the wrong decision. It simply means having a momentous significance of consequences, decisively important. That's what it means. That decision was decisively important. That choice and decision was given, amen, to His creation. You get to choose. Amen. You have the freedom to choose. You're not robots. God's not going to make you serve Him. Amen. But God gives you the choice, amen, today, to choose, amen. As Joshua said, choose ye this day in whom you will serve. As for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord. Praise God. As for me and my house, we're going to do what it is that God wants us to do. Praise God. That choice, that decision was given, praise God, hallelujah, to man on the day of creation. Praise God. The freedom to choose, amen. The freedom to allow God to give you the ability to choose. You see, He created the angels with the freedom to choose as well. Whether to be ministers of truth and life, but purveyors, or purveyors of lies and death. You see, humanity was created within easy reach. Perhaps even within sight of the tree of knowledge of good and evil. Praise God. Hallelujah. And at this moment, every one of us in this room, praise God, from the pulpit to the back door, have our future in our hands. We get to choose.
Right.
Amen. Your destiny is up to you.
That's right.
Praise God. Where you're going to spend eternity is up to you. Praise God. Amen. It's not God's will that any should perish, but that all should come into repentance. Amen. Amen. And so we have so many choices in this world today. Praise God. I believe all of heaven is holding its breath to see what you're going to do with the choice that you're given. Praise God. Hallelujah. We have so many choices. Amen. We can choose to believe, or we can choose not to believe. We can choose to be helpful, or we can choose not to be helpful. We can choose to be kind, or we can choose to be unkind. Amen. You can choose to be unfaithful in all the connotations of that word, unfaithful, or you can choose to be faithful. Praise God. Hallelujah. I'm here today, of course, to urge you to be faithful unto God. Be faithful to His Word. Be faithful to your prayer life. Be faithful to your service unto God. Be faithful to the things of God. Hallelujah. Uphold His Word. Amen. With your life. Praise God. The choice has always been there. Amen. From the time that Lucifer, the angel of light, chose to become envious of the Creator, instead of choosing to be a faithful, amen, servant of God. Faithful to His purpose. Faithful to what God had created him to be. Those choices of being faithful or not have apparently always existed. Amen. Praise God. And along with those choices comes consequences. Amen. Consequences. We are free to choose. Think about that. Yeah. Amen. God loved you enough to give you choice. Yeah. Praise God. But in reality, when we choose, we must realize that every choice comes with the consequences of our actions. Every choice that we do has a consequence. Amen. Our lives can be condensed into a series of choices and consequences, if you will. Amen. Matter of fact, Newton said this. Amen. He said this of the third law of motion. He said, for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction.
Right.
Amen. That is so true. Jesus said in John 10:10, I am come that they might have life. That's what Jesus said. He came that we might have life and that they might have it more abundantly. Praise God. Thank God for that. Amen.
Amen.
Are you glad that He came to give you life and to give you abundant life? Praise God. And so we have to ask the question, why is Satan come into this world? Well, he's come to kill. He's come to steal. He's come, amen, to just wreak havoc on lives. In Job 1:15, the Bible says that, you know, this thing that happened in Job's life killed all the servants. Amen. Right? And the Sabians fell upon them and took them away. Yeah, they have slain the servants with the edge of the sword, and I only am escaped alone to tell thee. The servant of Job comes running to Job and says, hey, I don't know what's going on, but everybody's dead except me. I'm the only one alive. That's some bad news to get. Amen. Verse 19 says that there came a great wind from the wilderness and smote the four corners of the house, and it fell upon the young men, and they are dead. That's verse 19 of Job, same chapter, verse 1. And then John 10:10 tells us this. The thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. The thief comes.
Yes.
That's what he comes for.
That's it.
Amen. To steal and to kill and to destroy.
That's
We all know in our minds which choice we should make.
Right.
Amen. It's not a secret. We all know what we should do.
Right.
Amen. So why do we often make the wrong choice? Why do we often come to that place in our life when temptation comes and the devil, amen, wants us to do something against the will of God? Why is it that we often fold? Amen. Romans 12:2 tells us not to be conformed to this world.
Right.
But to be ye transformed by the renewing of the mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. You see, we need to allow the Word of God, we need to allow the Spirit of God to transform our thinking. Amen. Because the devil likes to do nothing more than to get into our minds, amen, and to torment us, and to get us to believe a lie, and to be damned. That's what he does.
Right.
And so you need a transforming, I need a transforming of my mind, that I can accept the Word of God, and live the Word of God, and breathe the Word of God, and trust the Word of God. Yes.
Amen.
And that would prove what is good and acceptable and perfect will of God in your life. The perfect will of God is not for you to sin. The perfect will of God is not for you to put God on a back shelf somewhere. But the perfect will of God is for you to worship God. The perfect will of God is for you to serve Him. The perfect will of God is for you to love Him. Amen. The perfect will of God is for you to witness. Amen. Praise God. The world is looking with all of its might to press you into a certain mold. On our screen in a few seconds, you're going to see a video from Facebook. You got to go to bookmarks. Amen. Keith, over on the screen, find bookmarks. Praise God. Amen. No, it's on the other screen. Hallelujah. Praise God. You got to go to the internet, go to Google. And then go to bookmarks. Mm-hmm. Amen. Close that out. Hit the X on that. Just get to Google. To the blank page of Google. This is important. I got it. There you go. Now up in the top right corner, hit that bookmark. No, go down. Go down right there. Hit that. Amen. Praise God. Enlarge that and then hit play. If it will enlarge. If it's not, just go ahead and hit play. Just go ahead and hit play and you might be able to enlarge it afterwards. Just watch this for a minute and I'll explain. This is just an advertisement for a company in California. Thank you. That picture right there on the screen is a hydraulic press. The whole advertisement was about this company, amen, that makes parts for aircraft. Now that press that was in that video, amen, it's a hydraulic press. The company's name is Weber Metals. It's in Paramount, California. It's capable of generating up to 60,000 tons of pressure. 60,000 tons. Amen. Building that machine required more than 42,700 tons of concrete, 3,000 tons of steel for rebar and other embedments to hold the concrete together. Its machinery extends as much as 80 feet underground. Costs more than $180 million to make. And it is dedicated to one thing, taking ingots of molded iron, molded steel, and pressing those molten metals into parts used to manufacture aircraft. This gigantic instrument pales in comparison to the pressures that this world wants to bring to bear on you as it tries to press you into its mold. Think about that. The world wants to pressure us all the time. Pressure us to do what we want to do, to be the boss, to just entertain ourselves and take all the pleasures of the world. Pressures come from things like friends who say, come on, let's just go have some fun. Don't worry about God. Pressures come from the popular media that says this is how you need to fit into the world. Pressures come from our flesh that says, I don't want to sacrifice my pleasures. Mm-hmm. Pressures come from family members who say, but I want to take the easy path. Amen. And we even, though we know better, and we know well enough, praise God, Romans chapter 6, verse 23 clearly tells us that the wages of sin is death. We know that. Right? Mm-hmm. For the wages of sin is death. But the rest of it says the choice that we have. Mm-hmm. The rest of that scripture gives us a choice. But the gift of God is eternal life through Christ Jesus. You see, we have to choose to be faithful.
Right.
We have to choose to be faithful. Amen. 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 We have to choose to fight the good fight of faith. Amen. We have to choose to participate in and with the family of God. We have to choose, amen, to be a witness and reach for the lost and the hurting. Amen. You've heard my messages over the years, amen, praise God. And you hear me right now exhorting you to make the right choices in life. Stop playing games, amen. You can't fool God. Amen? Praise God. I hear amens. I see heads nodding. I see all this, amen. And so, yes, I want you to make the right choice. I want you to choose to be faithful to God's way. Amen. That's what a shepherd does. He wants the sheep to go on the right path. He wants the sheep to follow after. Amen. Right. To know his voice. Praise God. But we have to ask, how do we do that? How do we make those choices? How do we do that? The first and most important step and the choice is the one to put first. Amen. To take that tedious step onto the path of righteousness. Amen. It starts at the altar of repentance where you must make that decision to follow Christ, amen, and his teachings with all your heart. That's where it starts. It starts in your heart at an altar, amen, where you're saying to God, God, I know, God, I'm not living right. I know I'm not doing right. I know I haven't been faithful, God, but I need your help.
Yes.
And turn, the Bible says. Praise God. Then every day, after that initial step, amen, hallelujah, for the remainder of our lives, we have to make that same decision to repent every day, to come before God. God, today I'm going to serve you.
Yes, Jesus.
I'm not looking 100 years ahead. I'm not looking 50 years ahead. I'm not looking 25 years ahead. I'm just looking for tomorrow. God, I'm going to serve you today. And then tomorrow, God, I'm going to get up and say, God, today's the day. I'm going to serve you again, Lord. Amen. Praise God. Taking it one step at a time, one day at a time, one choice at a time. Praise God. And every day we make that decision, amen, to focus on Jesus Christ as our Lord and our Savior, to focus on his word, to be obedient unto his word, to not allow the adversary to come into our life and to twist it and to put things in front of us to distract us from the vision of Christ. Every day we make the conscious decision and the concerted effort to put ourselves into action for Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. We pray just like David did in Psalms 86:11. Teach me thy way, O Lord, and I will walk in thy truth. Unite my heart to fear thy name. Hallelujah. See, we take intentional actions to make our faith be active and to be a part of our daily walk every day. That's our choice. And that's the choice we need to make, amen, every day, not just on Sundays, not just on Thursday nights when it's a life group night, amen, but every day I got to serve God. Every day I'm going to walk on the road of righteousness. Every day I'm going to serve in holiness. Every day I'm going to honor God. Every day I'm going to live for him. Amen. James 2:17. Pretty strong scripture, but it's so true. Even so, faith, if it hath not works, is dead. You can call yourself a Christian all you want.
Right.
But if it doesn't do anything, if it doesn't live up to what the Word of God says, your faith is dead. The New Living Translation says it like this. Faith by itself isn't enough unless it produces good deeds. It is dead and useless. Now we're saved by faith. Our faith is what saves us. Amen. But faith that is dead isn't going to save us, friend. Faith that is dead is just words. That's all it is. It doesn't produce anything. It doesn't do anything. It doesn't show love. It doesn't show respect. It doesn't show faithfulness. It doesn't do any of that. It's just a word. It says, I'm a Christian. Without any action behind it. Without any faithfulness behind it. Without the right choices behind it. Amen. At every human interaction that we make, an intentional decision is needed to allow our faith in Christ to come through in our reactions, in our conversations, and throughout our love and compassion for the lost and for each other. Amen. And in order to know what Jesus Christ would want, we must make time in His Word a part of our everyday lives. You can't know Him if you're not reading about Him. Amen. You can't know Him if you don't know the Word of God. Amen.
True.
David said, "The Word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against you."
Yes.
We've got to have the Word on the inside. We got to have the Word, amen, taking and leading us and guiding us. It's the Word of God. It's the presence of God, the Spirit of God, the Holy Ghost in you and me. Praise God. Anybody in this room got the Holy Ghost?
Amen.
Anybody in this room listen to the Holy Ghost?
Amen.
Amen. So we have to know Him. We have to have a conscious effort, praise God, on our part.
Right.
In our prayer life, in our reading the Word of God, in our faithfulness unto Him. Praise God. Paul wrote to his son in the Lord, Timothy. You know what he told Timothy? The same thing that the Bible tells us. In 2 Timothy 2:15. Study to show thyself approved unto God. A workman that needeth not to be ashamed. Rightly dividing the word of truth.
Yes.
Amen. I'm not preaching a God that we can press into a mold that we make. That's not what I'm preaching. Amen. We can't mold God into our lifestyle. That doesn't work, friend.
Not at all.
Amen. I'm not preaching a faith that you can interpret to please your own ideas. Amen. There is no private interpretation. That's what the Bible tells me. Praise God. I'm not preaching a faith that will allow you to meander through life like a stream seeking a path, amen, of least resistance. I'm not preaching a faith that will take you to the throne of God only to be told, "Depart from me, you workers of iniquity. I never knew you." That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about faith. I'm preaching a faith that will set you free from the chains of sin and death. Amen. I'm preaching a faith that will challenge you to walk a path that is straight with guardrails. That will keep you from falling, amen, and failing into spiritual death. I'm preaching a faith that will lift up your eyes from the petty things of this world to the sublime glory of the living Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. I'm preaching a faith that will stretch you and test you sometimes. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Oh, yes.
Praise God.
Oh, yeah.
I'm preaching a faith that will transform your lifestyle, that will change you and question your old man as it molds you into a new creature in Christ. As 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, "Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Yeah. Behold, yeah. All things are become new." That's the faith I'm talking about today.
Jesus.
That's the choices that we have to make. Hallelujah. As the singers come, I'm getting ready to close.
Amen.
But I feel this so right in my spirit. Jesus asked when speaking of John the Baptist, "What went he out to see? A reed shaken with the wind?" Amen. You know what that means? This is how one author put it. Amen. He said, "We want to bend God to the sinner to make the sinner straight." But that doesn't work.
It don't work, sir.
That doesn't work.
No.
That's what Jesus was saying with the reed. What went you out into the desert to see a reed shaking with the wind? No! Our measurement isn't in, amen, those things of this world. Our measurement isn't in our neighbor. Our measurement isn't in your pastor. The measurement isn't in your church. But our measurement is the Word of God.
Right.
Amen. And so my question and my challenge to you this morning, right now, do you really think you can live for God without His Spirit living in your life? Without the Spirit leading and directing you in your choices. See, that's what the Spirit does. It leads us and guides us. It directs us. The apostle, amen, praise God, answered that question. He said, I can't. He said it so many times. He said, without the power of the Spirit of God in my life, I'm going to fail. He said, without the power of the Spirit of God in your life, we're going to fail. Amen. So regardless of where you think you are in God, because we all have our own opinions of ourselves, don't we? Amen. Hallelujah. Regardless of the spiritual condition of your life, standing before God, I'm opening up this altar today. Amen. I'm opening up the altar. Amen. Right now. And I want everyone to come and ask Him to fill you with His power. Fill you with His Spirit. As our text says in Psalms, we cannot lie to ourselves. Amen. Convincing ourselves that we're good with God. As Isaiah said, there's a highway called holiness.
Yes.
Amen. And so, will you come? Will you set your feet on the highway of holiness this morning? And come to this altar. Make a choice for Jesus Christ today. Make a choice that God, I got to change some things in my life. I got to be faithful. I got to study to show myself approved. I got to do what the Word of God asks me to do in my life. Let's stand to our feet. Amen. As the music begins to play and the songs begin to be sung, make your way down the aisle to this altar. Make your way here and talk to God.
Shadows deepen you. Do you know how the long won't stop life from getting through? We do.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord. Bless you, God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
My God.